I'm gonna start back here and just start to make my way down.
Hey everyone, it's me, Gia Gunn, and today I'm gonna show you how to get snatched with contour. Grab your bronzers, grab your brushes, and let's get into it. So for ages, drag queens and trans showgirls such as myself have been contouring our faces backstage to create whatever face structure that we desire. So for me personally, I've always contoured my cheeks to make them look a little bit more pulled back. I've always contoured under my chin, also just to give myself like more definition, and also right around my forehead, just to make my forehead also look a little bit smaller.
Okay, you guys, so for today's contour, I'm gonna be using the Farrah Contour and Blend Brush. I will be using a powder contour today. So because I already have a nice structure, I just like to turn to the side and that shows me kind of where I need to contour. I really use the light to show me what needs to be done. By the shape of the brush, you know how you wanna use this. So because it's at an angle, I'm gonna start back here and just start to make my way down. And then as I'm doing that, I also like to start blending it up because I personally really like my contour to blend up into my blush. So if you are doing a high glam look, I actually really like to darken this back here. Like if I'm gonna be on stage or something like that, I really also like to go back in and just make sure that it's really dark back there so that when you do look forward, it's like really snatched and dramatic and just contoured. So now I'm gonna move on to my jaw. So I'm gonna start actually now here at the bottom of my chin, and I'm not going up here as much as I am going under right on my jawline. And then kind of angle your face up a little bit and start to blend it down. So now I'm gonna move up to the forehead. I like to start close to my hairline. I usually start with more of a dabbing action versus like a rubbing action, just because I think contouring from my experience is best if you just kind of dab it on and then lightly blend it out. So the reason I like to contour my forehead is because I like it to appear smaller. So I'm also gonna go in on the other side right here by my temples, and I'm just going to keep on blending around. And the idea is to make it darker to lighter. So now that I really placed a lot of the contour, now I'll go in with the other side of the brush and just kind of feather it out and blend it in. And you can do this with like another translucent powder or just the brush, but I definitely wouldn't add more product. Now I'm gonna move on to my nose contour. So for that, I'm going to use the smaller side of the brush, and I'm just gonna apply a little bit of product. So for the nose contour, I really like to look at myself straight on just because that shows me what I'm doing. You're straight on looking at yourself, and now you're just gonna go from the inside and bring it down. I really like to bring the contour from up in here and down versus just from here and down. I think it looks just like more blendable. And if you can even kind of bring some of your eyeshadow along with it, I feel like that also really helps for a nice seamless look. Okay, so I've done half of my face. As you can see, it's nice and chiseled, nice and bronzed, and my features are super defined. And then on this side, I've only done up here, but not the cheeks or the jaw or the nose. And you can definitely see a big difference. All right, dolls, I really had so much fun teaching you all how to contour your faces in this video. I truly hope you were able to learn a few tricks of the trade. Don't forget where these beauty tips are coming from, okay? And congratulations, because you have won your own drag diploma in contouring. I hope you guys have a really, really lovely summer. Don't forget to grab your brushes and get snatched, and happy contouring. Mwah. Bye.